heard that solo before, I'm sure. It's one of the most listened to saxophone solos of all time. And in this video, we're gonna find out why it's basically a blueprint for how to craft a killer solo. Jay Metcalf here from BetterSax.com. I've been busy moving the last month, so I haven't posted a video for you in a while. I closed up the old studio, and now I'm in a new location, as you can see, working on setting up this new studio. Some of the clips I recorded were done back in the old one, so you're gonna see me jump back and forth in this video. This great saxophone solo is from the Whitney Houston recording of the fantastic Dolly Parton song, I Will Always Love You, which was a big mega hit in 1992. The saxophone player is Kirk Whalum, who is one of my personal favorite saxophonists. If by any chance you are somehow unfamiliar with his playing, I strongly recommend you go check out some of his recordings, which are incredible. Kirk Whalum is an extremely melodic saxophone player. His phrasing when he plays makes you think you're listening to a great vocalist, which by the way is an incredible way to improve your own phrasing. Go listen to some of your favorite singers and try to emulate the way they phrase melodies. I've transcribed this solo and written out transposed parts for concert instruments, B-flat and E-flat instruments. You can download that PDF for free in the Better Sax Shed. The link is below. Once you sign up for that, you'll get access to this transcription, as well as the other ones in my Great Saxophone Solos series, as well as tons of other practice material for learning how to get better at saxophone. It's all free, it's no catch. Knock yourself out and enjoy. Now, I learned this solo by ear, and I strongly recommend you do the same, even though I'm giving you the written out sheet music. And the reason is because it's actually easier to learn a solo like this by ear than to try to read the sheet music. As you can see, rhythmically, it looks rather complicated when written out. This is a ballad, so there's a lot of rhythmic subdivision going on. Earlier, I told you that Kirk Whalum plays the saxophone kind of like a vocalist, and so you've got all these free and very expressive phrases that don't lend themselves so well to being written out in notation. However, if you listen very closely and play it over and over again along with the recording, you can copy pretty much exactly the same phrasing just using your ear. Almost all of the notes in this solo come out of the major pentatonic scale or the blues scale, and there aren't any really fast passages with a lot of notes cramped in. There is one altissimo note, which is a bit of a challenge, but other than that, this solo is very approachable for all players. Now, if you want to get better at playing your saxophone by ear and learning melodies and solos like this without the sheet music, I strongly recommend you check out my Pentatonic Foundation and Blues Foundation courses. That's a complete method for developing this skill so that you can learn how to play the music you love and want to play on your saxophone. Now let's learn this solo phrase by phrase, and I will be speaking in concert key. The solo is a total of 8 measures long over the chords for the verse of the song. He starts out in the last bar of the chorus on the 5 chord, leading us into the top of the verse. This is a pentatonic scale line. Now he could have just played the E, the A, and the C sharp, right? But that would be a little less interesting. So think of all the other notes as embellishments of this main melodic phrase. Throughout this entire solo, he's basically just embellishing a simple melodic line. For example, if we take the first line of this solo, the overall melodic line is E, A, C sharp, B, A. But once we add all these vocalistic embellishments, we get this. The next phrase, again, is built on a simple descending melodic line. B, A, G sharp, F sharp, E. He's embellishing the overarching melody with the neighboring notes in the scale above and below. He throws in the flat third as a bluesy color here and there too. This is something we talked about in my Great Solos episode 3 video, where we looked at the David Sanborn solo over How Sweet It Is to Be Loved by You. That's the blues scale trick over a major tonality. Now, before he plays this F sharp here, he leads into it from further down, leaping up from the B. That wider interval changes things up nicely. Now, I don't know if Kirk did all of that on purpose, but I think this sort of very melodic playing kind of comes naturally to great musicians. While researching for this video, I came across this great clip of Kirk telling the story about this iconic recording.
And we did it live to the film. When you see The Bodyguard, we're actually backstage behind the curtain recording as she's playing. Ricky Minor's back there looking at her and looking at us. And we're playing. And I played my solo. He handed him the dat of the rough mix. And Clyde puts his headphones on and he's like, that's it, you know. And so, of course, the producer said, great, excellent. All right, can't wait to go in and, you know, add strings here and sort of, you know, I'm gonna fix that sax note. I'm gonna, you know, I'm gonna put some more reverb, you know, and blah, blah, blah. He's like, oh, no, no, no. No, that's it. So what you hear is literally the rough mix of that day.
So apparently this incredible recording that we've all heard a million times is a live first take with no overdubs, and it's brilliantly executed. Now for the second half of the solo, he starts out once again with that same melodic content, the E, A, C sharp, B, A. This repetition of melodic material is extremely effective when improvising solos, just like how the melody of a song repeats itself. Doing that in a solo can be very effective and really connects with the listeners. Now, for the last phrase of the song, he brings everything up to a climax by playing a high F sharp, which is a altissimo G sharp on the tenor saxophone. That's a challenging note, but the effect of going up to that altissimo range near the end of the solo kind of sets up the peak, and then he brings it down and puts it to rest as we come back into the last verse. Notice that the overarching melody of this line follows the major pentatonic scale down. F sharp, E, C sharp, B, A, F sharp, E. So check it out. Another way to think of this solo is as a simple melodic line that gets connected with a lot of interesting embellishments. I've written that line out for you as well, and it's on the PDF. Now, as an exercise, you can try to improvise your own solo based on this melodic line. Just add your own embellishments to connect the notes. I think that in itself is a great lesson on how to craft a solo that really connects well with the audience. Another very interesting thing to notice in this solo is that every time the chord changes, Kirk plays a chord tone on the downbeat of the chord change. So not only does this solo have a very nice underlying melody to it, but that melody has great voice leading and outlines the harmony very nicely. Now you may be saying to yourself, when you break it all down like that, it seems so simple. Surely it must be more complicated with lots of fancy stuff going on for it to sound so good. Not really. Sometimes the most beautiful and tasty things are quite simple and composed of the most basic ingredients. I hope you learned something from this video. Go ahead and download the free PDF linked below and go listen to some Kirk Whalum. Everything that man plays is like a masterclass in sound, phrasing, and melody. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.